Welcome to TV20 Classic Sports. I'm your host, Christian Patterson. From all-star matchups to championship games, we've reached into the vault to bring back a part of Cleveland history. Now sit back, relax, and enjoy this episode of TV20 Classic Sports.
Welcome to the 1994 City of Cleveland Division of Recreation House League Flag Football Championship.
Brookside Park, and welcome to the Morgana Championship game. I'm Ron Yance along with Tim Wells, and Tim, we have the Cowboys against the Raiders in this championship game in the Morgana League, and you have told me that this is going to be a very well-matched game and a good game to watch.
It's going to be exciting, Ron. We're going to look at two teams going at it that have played each other all year, and it's really a Cinderella story. We had some teams that were 10-0 that were at Morgana get knocked out by these teams, teams that were 9-1. The two teams we have here today have a real very similar story. One started out at 4-0, ended up finishing up at 5-5, but winning two games in the playoffs. The other one struck out with 0-4 and came back and finished their season at 4-6. But got strong in the playoffs, routing teams 54-6. They were last in offense. Coach credits, hey, we had a couple guys with the bad attitudes. They're gone, we're back, and it's going to be a great game.
Tim, these teams have played twice this year with the Raiders winning the first match 32-9 and the Cowboys winning the second one 18-14. But you said there are some players in this game that people should really keep an eye on.
Well, it's like a dream come true when we look at a Super Bowl, the Cowboys and the Raiders. And in white, they're going to see the Cowboys today on offense. They're going to throw it probably 70% of the time. But here are some of the keys, and we talked to Barney James, their coach, about what do you need to do to win. And he said, we have to have a defensive pass rush. Tim, this game is going to be won on the lines. The quarterbacks are going to play a big play. The two guys they're talking about are number 10, Santo Ortiz, and number 5, Anthony Linderman. Both coaches agreed when we talked to them it's going to be the pass rush. Which ones can put pressure on the quarterbacks? The two outstanding quarterbacks are Chris Osborne for the Cowboys and Joe Barrett from the Raiders. Both of them can run, both of them can throw, and both of them are smart quarterbacks. So I look for this to be an outstanding football game.
Tim, the Cowboys are wearing white. The Raiders are out on the field, and they are wearing black, and both teams standing on the field right now. So let's go out there and meet the teams.
Welcome back to Brookside Park for the third and final game of our 1994 Flag Football Championships. The final game is our Morgana Junior League Championship. First of all, I'd like to introduce the Cowboys. Number one, Edward Farmer. Number two, Chris Osborne. Number three, Jeff Leahy. Number four, Thomas Skladowski. Number five, Anthony Lindemann. Number six, Antoine Todd. Number seven, Julius Johnson. Number eight, James O'Reilly. Number nine, Jay Bilski. Number 10, Santo Ortiz. Number 11, Robert Bolang. And number 18, Bailey Davis. The Cowboys are coached by head coach Barney James. And now for the introduction of the Raiders. Number 2, George Upsey. Number 4, Tony Cizlak. Number 5, Joe Von Barrett. Number 7, Adam Kowalski. Number 9, Henry Joseph. Number 10, Bill Konarzewski. Number 17, Jack Fargo. Number 18, Ross Augustino. Number 12, Jeremy Jones. And the Raiders are coached by assistant coach Ross Augustino. And head coach Floyd Konarzewski.
Tim, the Raiders in black with the Cowboys in white. Both teams shaking hands at midfield right now. And in just a second, we'll get together with the Morgana Championship game. But first, let's meet tonight's officials.
Well, again, we'll look on the left. It'll be Joe Yee. As we're looking at Kim Kibbord, she's in from Estabrook Recreation next to Joe. We're going left to right. Chris Scott from Fairfax Recreation. And Frank Montez has been our head referee all night. And we'll go to our coin toss. We're looking at the center manager from Stella Walsh Recreation Center, Marty Pizak, a veteran center manager, one of our most outstanding workers in the Division of Recreation.
Your choice, black.
Defer to second half. You're gonna receive?
Yes.
What goalie's like to defend? Okay.
Shake hands. Good luck to both of you.
Let's get ready to rumble.
Thank you.
Get a flag. Get a flag.
So, Tim, the Cowboys win the toss. They have elected to receive. The Raiders will defend first. Moments away from the Morgana Championship game. The Cowboys against the Raiders.
And it's going to be the Cowboys and the Raiders for the championship as we look at the two coaches. As we look at the Cowboys head coach, they're really different in contrast. Barney James is a student aide, played a little football at Cleveland Central Catholic. This is the first time he's ever been involved in flag football, and he kind of just learned and watched the season went on, and the kids kind of called their own plays, and things fell in place for him. On the other hand, Floyd Konarzewski, he's been doing this for 2 years. He's a graduate of South High, played under John Gentile back years ago. So he's been through the tough-minded coaches, and he kind of has a philosophy, hey, we're going to play together and kind of draw on each other for support. He was in last year's championship game and lost in overtime. So he's been here before, as well as Barney James. This is the first time for him, so it should turn out to be an interesting game.
There are the Raiders wearing black, lined up at the 20. They are set to kick off to the Cowboys. Cowboys in white. Morgana championship game here, a senior league game, so each quarter will be made up of 14 plays. And we've got trouble on the kickoff. Trouble for the Cowboys. And the Raiders recover. So it will be the Raiders football. The Raiders kicked off to the Cowboys, but a fumble and the turnover goes the Raiders' way.
Okay, what has happened here again, this is league rules and safety issues. We can't have onside kicks. The ball was fumbled. It was in an area where people can get hurt. So they ruled the ball dead, and the Cowboys will take over almost midfield.
So a break for the Cowboys. At quarterback for the Cowboys, Chris Osborne. Osborne wearing the purple ski hat, and the pass there goes to his number one wide receiver, Ed Farmer, and Farmer crosses the midfield stripe, so that will give the Cowboys a first down. Chris Osborne, number two, at quarterback for the Cowboys, a 15-year-old, 5'9", 135-pounder, a sophomore at East Tech High School. Number two, Chris Osborne, the quarterback for the Cowboys. First down situation for the Cowboys, first series of the game. Morgana championship game. Pass across the middle, another completion, and the Cowboys down just 4 yards short of another first down. The pass went to Santo Ortiz that time. Ortiz, a sophomore from South High School, picked up the pass and picked up about 10 yards after it. So right away, the Cowboys coming out, Tim, throwing the football and moving it. Second down for Chris Osborne. Osborne, the lefty, rolling left back to the right. Screen pass works perfectly and almost all the way for a touchdown. Anthony Lindemann comes up about 5 yards short on his pass from Osborne. And basically what happened there is it was in effect a screen. I mean, just a little dump off to Lindemann, and Lindemann took it the rest of the way.
Pass complete to Tony Lindemann.
Now there's a penalty on the play here. Again, you can see, Ron, what they've done is they've gone to the lineman, Anthony Lindemann. Early in the ball game, we've mentioned three names, Santo Ortiz, Chris Osborne, and Lindemann. We've told you those are three key players that they need to keep their eye on, as well as they have an outstanding wide receiver in Ed Farmer. He's number one, and he's someone we need to keep an eye on.
The penalty is on the Cowboys.
So the block in the back.
Long completion is nullified.
We're locking down.
Second down for Osborne and his Cowboys. And I'm not quite sure if Chris Osborne knew exactly what he wanted to do on that play.
Yeah, one of the schemes that the Cowboys have seemed to use in the playoffs is that they do look for primarily for their wide receivers to get them involved. But again, if it's safety valves, he'll look for the lineman, he'll look for the center. At that time, he was looking for Daley Davis to come through and make the catch for him.
Now, I believe this is third down. They haven't switched it. The pass incomplete to Julius Johnson from Osborne. First series of the game for the Cowboys. Cowboys against the Raiders, the Morgana championship game. The down marker has stayed at second down for the last three plays, so we'll disregard that, but we will tell you that that pass right there will get the Cowboys a first down. The pass from Osborne to Anthony Lindemann. And Lindemann with a pass reception. Lindemann, a freshman at Lake Catholic High School. The key receiver in short passing situations.
Looks at a replay here again. It's coming right off the line. Lindemann wide open, over the middle, short passing game, picks up the first down.
And on the first play after the first down, Osborne again completes a pass to someone on the far sideline. The crowd that is down there kind of blocked my view here, but the pass play does pick up 3 yards, and Osborne will face a second down situation. Pressure, but he gets it off. And I tell you what, if Julius Johnson holds onto that football, they have a touchdown.
Now that's two they've thrown to Julius Johnson's way. Both times, you see him rubbing the hands, trying to stay warm here.
Go down.
Julius is a seventh grade student at A.B. Hart.
Third down for the Cowboys. Osborne flushed, rolling left, pass in the corner of the end zone, and they have a touchdown.
There he is, Ed Farmer, number one. Coach told us before the game, Ron, hey, this is the guy we're going to go to. He's the guy that can make or break us tonight. Look for him to be involved. You see here, he rolls to his left. Hands are up. Hey, throw it up here. Now, one of the things that Coach Karnazowski told us before the ball game was his concern was his defensive backs are not as tall as the wide receivers. Here's where one time they threw it up and hit the wide receiver.
The two-point conversion attempt will go to Lindemann, and it will be completed for a two-point conversion. So the touchdown by the Cowboys followed by the two-point conversion pass to Anthony Lindemann, and the Cowboys take the first series of this first quarter all the way for a touchdown. 8-0 Cowboys over the Raiders. The Raiders yet to get the football here in the Morgana Championship game. Tim, right away, you mentioned three names before we started. Chris Osborne, the quarterback, Anthony Lindemann, and Ed Farmer, and those are the three guys that we saw on that drive.
Again, here's a Cowboy team that ended up losing like four out of five games and has come back strong here to get into the playoffs and right into the championship game. And you can see here that Chris Osborne and this Cowboy team is playing with a lot of confidence right now.
So the Cowboys will kick off to the Raiders, and the Raiders wearing black will get their first opportunity at the football. And returning it for the Raiders to midfield is George Hopsey. George, 5'3", 120 pounds, an eighth grader at A.B. Hart School. So the Raiders start right at midfield.
Kickoff return by Henry Joseph.
The first down marker next for the Raiders is at the 20, so they need 20 yards to go. And we're going to have a flag, so this play will be called back, but it will go for a touchdown in the meantime. Joe Barrett, the quarterback for the Raiders, does a little dance on his way into the end zone, but it's all coming back, fellas, because there's a flag near the 50-yard line or midfield.
Now, right on the first play, you notice they use a little bit of misdirection to get Joe Barrett involved. And one of the concerns that Barney James said is we need to handle their misdirection play. Obviously, I think what's happened here is we've got a... Okay, they've called an illegal block in the back on the offense. But that's a play that the Cowboys are going to see, and the Raiders run it well. They do use a lot of misdirection. They're also going to throw off some flea flickers. They got a lot of creativity in their offense, and they run it extremely well.
So the play negates a 40-yard touchdown run by Joe Barrett, and one thing I noticed on that, Tim, is Barrett can run. He went by people. He got to the sideline, and no one came close to catching it.
Well, when you look at Joe Barrett, he is the one of the leading scorers, 157 points during the regular season.
Barrett at quarterback. The pass is intercepted by Farmer, and Farmer may be on his way to a touchdown. Ed Farmer, the interception at the 30, and he returns it for a Cowboys touchdown.
Edward Farmer for a touchdown.
Wow, what a change of events that was. Barrett runs 40 yards for a touchdown. It's called back for a holding penalty. And then the next pass, Farmer intercepts and takes it 30 yards the other way for a Cowboys score.
Well, one of the things is you can see here, Ed Farmer cuts across the field. Again, both Farmer number one and as well as number five was out there leading the block. So the Cowboys are picking each other up here early in the ball game.
Osborne going for the three-point conversion, and the pass to Lindemann counts. Lindemann with a nice catch. Farmer, Osborne actually with a nice pass there. And the Cowboys at a three-point conversion.
That's correct.
So we go from 8-0 to a potential 8-6 with a score by Barrett, called back by a penalty, then an interception and a three-point conversion later, and this score is 17-0. Cowboys, very early, just first quarter, nine plays into the quarter.
You look here, Chris Osborne, had a lot of pressure, got the pass off to Anthony Lindemann. Again, touchdown. One of the keys, Ron, we talked about was pass rush. The Raiders are getting there, but they're not there in time. There is some pressure, and that's something we need to keep an eye on during the football game. The defensive pass rushes from both teams.
This is not the way that head coach Floyd Kunarczewski wanted to start this football game for his Raiders. The Raiders will once again get good field position. Last possession, they started right at the midfield stripe. This possession, they'll start 2 yards inside that at the 38 of the Cowboys.
Kickoff return by Henry Jr.
The Raiders with a 5-5 record during the regular season. They've played the Cowboys twice this year. The Raiders won the first matchup 32-9. The Cowboys the second one 18-14. Cowboys lead 17-0 here early in the first quarter. Fake the handoff. Barrett to throw. He's got an open receiver, but he's a little long on it. Mike Chapman couldn't quite bring it in, and Joe Barrett's pass will fall incomplete.
Incomplete.
Coming up, play number 11 in the first quarter. They'll play 14 plays in each quarter here in the Morgana Junior League Championship.
Second down.
Second down situation for the Raiders. They need 18 yards for a first down. Barrett in the shotgun. Now that is switched. Barrett comes up to the line. When Barrett came up to the line that time, Tim Jack Fargo came up to quarterback for the Raiders, and Fargo threw the pass there looking for Tony Cieslak.
One of the things that Floyd Kunarczewski has done with the Raiders is he's made it where they're going to use a lot of motion. They're going to try to keep Barrett moved in different positions so that it's hard to defense him. Obviously, Joe Barrett is the key to the Raiders. He has good speed. We saw him from the quarterback position, also from the receiver's position. So I think what they're going to see is a lot of motion, a lot of stuff trying to get him freed up.
Barrett at quarterback with three wide receivers out, and Barrett overthrows that time Tony Cieslak. So maybe the Raiders still shaking up a little bit from what happened there in their first series.
Well, one of the keys was before the ball game, the Cowboys, one of the concerns that Coach James says, we got to play with confidence. If we get behind big, we could really have a problem. That hasn't happened. Also, we talked about Lindemann before the ball game. Here was another situation where Anthony Lindemann was in the backfield when Joe Barrett wanted to make it. So the pressure is there for them, for the Cowboys.
So the Raiders face a fourth down situation. They will punt. Punting for the Raiders is Daley Davis. Actually, no, that wasn't Daley Davis.
That was Russ Augustino.
You switched the numbers on me, Tim, and you didn't tell me.
Russ Augustino is the one that did the punt. And again, the officials marking it out of bounds. Truthfully, it's a great punt, Ron. We look here that they're spotting the ball actually on about the 1 yard line. So this is a break for the Raiders. And again, you look at two tough teams in a tough ball game. Although it's 17-0, this is a break for the Raiders. It was special teams that beat the Floyd Kunarczewski's team a year ago, he told me, in overtime. This time it was a special teams play that's put his defense in a great position.
So Chris Osborne stands in the shotgun in his own end zone. The Cowboys 78 yards away from the other end zone. This should be the last play of the first quarter.
This should be the last play of the first quarter.
Seventeen to nothing, the Cowboys over the Raiders. First quarter action here in the Junior League Morgana Championship game. That's Osborne. Osborne takes it out himself, and Chris Osborne picks up about 10 yards before his flag is grabbed.
Can't ride Chris Osborne.
Tim, that'll wrap up the first quarter. 14 plays in the quarter, so Osborne and his teammates will switch sides. 17-0 our score, and Tim, you talked early that you expected this to be a very good game, an evenly matched game, and the Cowboys have kind of stunned the Raiders here early, haven't they?
Well, again, it was a big play on a turnover. The Cowboys came out with a lot of confidence in a short pass, moved the ball down the field and scored. Obviously, the biggest play that's happened is the touchdown called back, come back. Ed Farmer comes up with an interception, runs it back in 17-0. The Raiders are an outstanding football team. They are going to come back here, and they're going to score, and it's going to be a great game, Ron.
Osborne in the first quarter, 5 of 8 for 50 yards passing. Chris Osborne, the quarterback for the Cowboys. Farmer, his receiver, has 2 touchdowns so far, the one catching and then the one interception that he returned for a touchdown, and no offensive yards for the Raiders in the first quarter of play.
One of the things about the Raiders is during the regular season, not only did Joe Barrett lead the league in scoring, but he also led it in interceptions. They create a lot of turnovers on interceptions, so that's something we need to be aware of.
Very important for the Raiders to hold the Cowboys deep in their own end. Osborne passes out to Julius Johnson that time, and just slightly overthrown. So the Cowboys obviously trying to get out of that hole right now, and the Raiders would like nothing more but to keep them in it.
Again, our viewers are watching the Morgana League Championship. This is a league that was organized by Stella Walsh Recreation Center and their league director, Jim Clark.
Osborne across the middle, and that one almost picked off by the Raiders there. Russ Augustino, freshman at South High. Old Ross almost had an interception that they could have, if they picked that off and either Augustino goes in or gives them great field position, that suddenly changes things. Fourth down, though. So the Raiders have done what they wanted to do. They wanted to keep the Cowboys deep in their own end, so the Cowboys will punt on fourth down, and the Raiders should get good field position out of it.
Now, again, in flag football, they have a right to declare what they're doing. Here's a punt. No pass rush again for safety reasons.
Augustino will return the punt. Augustino got a good return going there, and Santo Ortiz ended it early. Nonetheless, the Raiders will start off in great field position here to start the second quarter. 3 plays into the second quarter. The Raiders with the ball on the Cowboys' 26-yard line. The Cowboys, as you see, with a 17-0 lead. 2 touchdowns by Ed Farmer in the first period have been all the scoring for the Cowboys. We're going to get an offsides penalty this time, and I believe, Tim, it's going to go on number 10 there for the Cowboys,
Santo Ortiz. We had asked the coach before the ball game about, his players, and one of the things he told us about Santo Ortiz is that he's the fastest player on my team, and he leads our team in sacks. Again, anticipating the count.
Usually when you got a guy that gets a lot of sacks, he jumps off sides a few times. Michael Dean Perry for the Browns is one. So there's Ortiz. He got to the quarterback, I believe, before he got the pass off.
Correct. It was a sack.
So just as we've talked, Ortiz comes up with a sack. Raiders will lose about a yard on the play. They'll face second down.
Look at the replay here. We can see a little bit of misdirection, try a fake here. And again, it's number 10, Santo Ortiz, as well as number 2, Chris Osborne, in on the tackle.
Second down, right back up the middle, this time for the Raiders. And they go all the way for a touchdown. Joe Barrett on the quarterback draw takes it 23 yards for a Raider touchdown.
Touchdown by Joe Barrett.
Well, we've talked about Joe Barrett's speed. Again, the Cowboys were in a defense where they wanted to contain. Middle was wide open, couple missed tackles. Joe Barrett walks in the end zone for another touchdown. Again, he was the leading scorer in the Morgana League this year we can see why.
A lot of points too, Tim. 157 points for Joe Barrett. So Barrett will line up looking for the two-point conversion here, and Joe Barrett will not get it. A nice defensive play that time for the Cowboys, nullifying the conversion attempt by the Raiders.
Yeah, and it was Anthony Litterman that came up across the field, showed some speed of his own. Again, on the defensive line, we've talked about Anthony Litterman, Ortiz, but again, it was Joe Barrett that put the Raiders on the board. They run straight up the middle, 25-yard touchdown run. Cowboys now 17, Raiders 6.
So good news for the Raiders. They get on the scoreboard and kind of even things out here, although, you know, they're down 11. But as you said, Tim, they look to that Farmer interception returned as a touchdown as, you know, a big play and something that, you know, that they'll have to get back on. But they certainly wanted to score a touchdown, and they've done that now. We're just five plays into the second quarter, so obviously a whole lot of time left in this game. And Cowboys will get the ball on the kickoff here. Raiders kicking off to the Cowboys. Ortiz with the kickoff, and Ortiz at the midfield stripe, and Santo Ortiz was two people away from breaking that one for a touchdown.
Returned by Santo Ortiz. Talk about Ross.
When we look here at the replay, we can see Ortiz goes back. And again, he's looking for some direction to see where the holes are. Again, nice cut move across one way. And then you're going to see he's going to cut back to the other side. He gets two more blocks. He could be gone. But again, it's a tackle by number five of the Raiders for the stop.
Back to action. There you see the end of the play. Number two with the purple ski cap is Chris Osborne, the quarterback. Osborne kept the ball himself. He rolled right on the play and picked up about 10 yards down to the 23, and that's where the Cowboys will have it second down. Osborne at quarterback. Again, looks to run, tucks it in. He'll get the first down. And Osborne wants a little more, but he only gets about 2 yards. So he got goal number one, which is a first down, and that gives the Cowboys four new plays of trying to score a touchdown. Tim, the Cowboys not wasting any time here. I mean, the ball is placed down, and they're ready to go. Osborne again, pass to Ortiz, and it's complete.
Pass complete for Santo Ortiz.
But you can see that these teams are well organized on both ends of the ball. Again, Chris Osborne has a lot of latitude. Barney James has told me, hey, there's times where I'm going to let him go ahead and call his own plays. He's a smart quarterback for me.
So Osborne and the Cowboys, 10 yards away from the score. Osborne looking for someone, and he finds
Anthony Litterman.
Litterman, his second touchdown of the day.
Scored by Tony Litterman on a pass from Chris Osborne.
Anthony Litterman wearing the Chief Wahoo inside of his cap there. Litterman, a freshman from Lake Catholic High School, the key receiver for the team, the Cowboys.
Looking at the replay here again, he gets behind his receiver and walks in for the touchdown.
Osborne going for the conversion, and Osborne will get it. So the two-point conversion, correct?
Correct. Two-point conversion because it was run in. Now makes it
25-6. 25-6. We're counting as we go.
Well,
the calculator's broken.
I told you, Ron, this was going to be one of those high-scoring games, right? No, I don't think I did. I think I said it was going to be great defense.
I don't know, Mike over there is not quite so sure that you know exactly what you're talking about, Tim.
Well, he's been saying that all night.
Cowboys with the 25-6 lead. We are seven plays into the second quarter, so that means we have seven plays left in the quarter, and then we'll be at the halftime mark. The Morgana Championship game, the Junior League. Chris Osborne, the quarterback for the Cowboys. He's thrown for two touchdown passes tonight, and completed a few passes on the way too.
Hey, 7 for 12 for 65 yards, two touchdown passes.
the Raiders returning it, and we got a flag down, but a nice return anyways by Joe Barrett, the quarterback. Flag came from the mid part of the field.
Julius Johnson, flag on the play.
Got a block in the back. Excuse me, 13. Spot of the foul, 10 yards back.
Block in the back on the Raiders.
Let's see if we can pick it up here. Again, it's, I think they're calling it on number 4. The only thing I saw close to a block in the back was number 4 on our replay.
So instead of having the ball in Cowboys territory at about the 35-yard line, the Raiders will have the ball at their own 35. First down for the Raiders. They are down 25-6. Joe Barrett keeps it himself, and Ortiz takes care of Barrett right away.
Carry by Joe Barrett, tackled by Santos Ortiz. Second down.
Here we are looking at Santo Ortiz. He also played over at Stella Walsh in the Mickey Mantle baseball program this past summer. And we can see here, comes up with another tackle.
This is the 11th play of the quarter. Barrett hands it off and goes out for the pass, and Chris Osborne intercepts it.
Interception by Chris Osborne.
So Chris Osborne does a nice job defending that time on the
Cowboys ball.
I don't know what you want to call that, Tim, but
well, you can see here they did a little flea flicker or reverse. They handed off back to him, and Barrett came out on this sideline. But again, the safety, Chris Osborne, had 7 interceptions during the regular season. He wouldn't buy it. He picks off an interception in the championship game here tonight. We see the officials conferring. At halftime, Ron Desiree is going to be talking to Marty Pizak, who is the center manager from Stella Walsh Recreation Center, and he'll be telling you about some of the programs and things that are available to the residents in his community.
We'll look forward to that. 25-6 our score, the Cowboys over the Raiders. Cowboys with the ball on offense. 12th play of the second quarter, so there are 3 more plays here to go in the second quarter, then we'll have halftime. Chris Osborne back at quarterback for the Cowboys. Osborne goes deep. He has an open man. It's Ed Farmer, and Ed Farmer is off for a touchdown. Just like that, the Cowboys strike like lightning.
Touchdown. Pass from Chris Osborne to Ed Farmer.
Tim, this has been a lethal combination tonight. Osborne to Farmer. Nice pass, and Ed Farmer does the rest.
Hey, tell Mike down there that we talked about Ed Farmer and his speed, that we talked about not just the short passing game, but Ed Farmer's speed and the long passing game, and right here we saw a little bit of it.
Mike, of course, keeping stats for us tonight along with Dennis
Hill.
Guy's doing a great job and going for the 3-point conversion attempt past that time, trying to get to Lindeman, and it falls incomplete. So they'll get the 6 points for the touchdown, the Cowboys will, and they'll take a 31-6 lead. Is that the last play of the half?
No, we're play number 12.
I believe that was play, the touchdown was play number 12, the 2-point conversion.
Two more plays, right. Played 14 plays.
So we've got 2 more plays to go here, and the kickoff won't count as a play.
When you look at this Cowboy package in the first half, kind of impressive. They have a short passing game. You have Chris Osborne, heady quarterback, and all those left-handed quarterbacks, they say, will drive the defenses crazy. You can see here, Chris Osborne not only has done it through running, he's also done a short passing, and he's had the speed in Ed Farmer that he's been able to go to.
You know, Chris Osborne, a sophomore at East Tech, and the Scarabs, as far as high school football is concerned, off to a real great start this year in Senate play. And I can't imagine that Chris Osborne can't be used on that football team. I mean, he's got a lot of nice movement, and as you said, a left-handed quarterback can throw the football. He looks really good tonight. That's Barrett. Barrett has done an outstanding job on returning kickoffs tonight. The Raiders have usually ended up with pretty good field position, and it's been Barrett every time.
Well, we talked about Joe Barrett and the outstanding game he's had so far, and it's been Chris Osborne as well, 8 for 13, 113 yards. We're looking here at the kickoff. We're going to see a little bit of Joe Barrett in action. Again, both teams come up. Nice wall formed here, 18, number 4. See here a block on Santo Ortiz, just gets around him, but Anthony Lindeman comes up for the tackle.
Raiders on offense, and they have not been very effective on offense tonight. The Cowboys have held the Raiders to 19 total yards in the first half. Barrett with the pass, and that one will fall incomplete. Joe Barrett trying to go along the sideline there to Mike Chapman.
Joe Barrett's pass incomplete.
And covered well by Osborne.
Now, one of the things on that play, Ron, that you saw was they used a little bit of misdirection, but Santo Ortiz, the right end, was right in the face of Joe Barrett. Again, they had talked about that before the game, handle the misdirection, pressure on the quarterback. So not only on offense has the Cowboys been able to keep it together, but also on defense, their defensive line and free safety Chris Osborne's really made it happen for him.
Tim, I believe this is the last play of the first half. Barrett will go into the end zone and no one's there. So the first half will end on that incompletion pass by Joe Barrett. And what a first half it has been for the Cowboys. The Cowboys have come out and they have stung the Raiders. I don't think the Raiders expected this, and I'm not quite sure that the Cowboys did either. I know that we didn't, but nonetheless, the Cowboys have really played well this first half.
Okay, well, we're at half. It's 31-6, and we'll take a timeout. When we come back, we'll meet the center manager from Stella Walsh Recreation Center.
Apagado bien sus fogatas. Si hubieran apagado sus cigarros antes de tirarlos. Si no hubieran tirado sus cerillos antes de apagarlos. Si no hubieran. Si no hubieran. Si no hubieran. Pero los hubieras de nada sirven. Les habla Smokey Bear. Solo usted puede prevenir incendios en los bosques.
Which child deserves to be read to? This one? Or is it this one? Which child will learn to use a toothbrush? Who will have a chance to sing? The choice is yours. Volunteer for Head Start. With your help, more low-income preschool children can get what other children already have. Change the world of a child, and you change the world.
Hi, we're here at halftime of the Morgana Junior League for flag football. We're here with the center manager, Marty Pizak from Stella Walsh. How are you doing tonight?
Okay, Des, how are you?
Good. Marty, you've been with the city of Cleveland for a couple of years now. How many years have you been a center manager?
I've been a center manager for 12 years, and I've been with the city of Cleveland for 22, going on 23 years.
Okay. With all the experience that you have with the city of Cleveland, what is it that motivates you to come in day to day and provide the programming that you do through the Stella Walsh Recreation Center?
Well, Des, if you're out here today, you can see what motivates people. It's basically for kids. Kids coming out and having a good time and getting to do things that they don't really get a chance to do. And that's what recreation is about, is dealing with our young people today. Giving them opportunities they would not have if it wasn't for our recreation centers.
Okay. We've been here tonight. We've seen the Corey Glenville League, the Alexander Hamilton League. Now we're looking at the Morgana game. Where did Morgana League come from, and why is it not called Stella Walsh?
Well, the reason is 2 years ago when we started this league, we were at Washington Park. But Washington Park didn't have lights, and we were getting in about one game a night. So we moved over to Morgana. Morgana is a central area around our rec center that has lights and a ball field that we could play ball at. So it was easier for the kids to relate to Morgana rather than tell them to come to Stella Walsh to go to Morgana. So we named it the Morgana League. And with advertisement in the neighborhood news and stuff, we named it the Morgana League.
okay, with the participation that you have at Stella Walsh and with the years that you've put in at Stella Walsh, I take it that you have a large, committed group of young individuals within your neighborhood that support the programs year after year, so you see a large turnover of participants for each program?
Well, this year we served 125 kids. Last year we served about 110 kids. The word is out. Kids are coming out from all over for all our events, not only our House League football, but also our House League basketball. So, you know, recreation in Cleveland is on a move. It's on a move up, and the kids need it, and they're coming out for it. And I advise all parents in the city of Cleveland to get out to their local rec center and take advantage of having their kids involved in a program like this.
Well, we want to thank you for taking the time out tonight to speak with us. Congratulations for the success that your league has, and good luck in the second half with the Cowboys and the Raiders.
Well, Des, thank you very much, and I'd like to thank everybody in recreation for giving us this opportunity and having this place all set up like this. Thank you.
Thank you. And back to more flag football.
About how you can help stop domestic violence, call us.
Someone out there needs help, and you've decided to save them. Every year, thousands of people die waiting for organ and tissue transplants. To be a donor, even if you've signed something, you must tell your family now so they can carry out your decision later. Otherwise, it's like throwing a 12-foot rope to someone who's 15 feet away. Share your life. Share your decision.
129 yards.
Right in the bathroom.
Welcome back to Elder Field, Brookside Park, the site for the Morgana League Championship game. Halftime score, you see it right there, the Cowboys 31, the Raiders 6. Ron Yance along with Tim Wells, and Tim, a special guest we have up here with us, Marty Pizak, and maybe you two guys can talk about what happened in the first half between the Cowboys and the Raiders.
Well, Marty, you've seen these teams all year. A little surprising, Cowboys, big lead, Raiders, what do you think?
Well, I think the Cowboys have really showed that they've come together as a team. In their last four or five ball games, they've really come out and played ball together, and it definitely showed in the first half.
Okay. Ron, we got a big surprise for Marty. Marty, we understand that you're a coach over at Stella Walsh.
Yeah, sometimes I would say I'm a coach at Stella Walsh.
Big game coming up. Just your team qualified for the tackle championships in the city of Cleveland. When we get time, maybe you can tell us a little bit about your game coming up.
All right.
The Cowboys kicking off to the Raiders. The Raiders with a lot of work to do on offense, down 31-6. And the Raiders are going to get the ball once again in good field position. And a late flag is thrown in. We'll wait and find out what that's all about, but the Raiders with the ball right now on the Cowboys' 39-yard line. And that will change by 10 yards because the Raiders are flagged for a block in the back.
Again, when we talked about both teams at the beginning of the game, I'm sure that when the coach looked at special teams, he thought that that had to play a big role. But obviously, we've seen a lot of penalties so far on special teams, on kickoffs, that have hurt the Raiders in positions.
Yeah, absolutely. The key thing you said there is on the kickoffs, they've had pretty good returns, and they've usually been accompanied by a penalty. So the Raiders will take over on offense. Of course, their quarterback, as he has been all night long, Joe Barrett. Barrett in the backfield there with the black ski cap on. And we've seen this play once before tonight, too. Barrett splits out as a wide receiver and passes on the side. Complete, but then incomplete. A nice breakup there by Jay Bilski for the Cowboys. The pass trying to get to Tony Cieslak of the Raiders.
Well, we saw Jay Bilski get involved on the defensive end. He's an eighth grader at Charles Elliott. Also runs some track over there. Saw the quickness. again, the Cowboys defense playing with a lot of confidence. Everyone's getting involved.
Tim, maybe we can talk to Marty about you're coaching a team that says is down 31-6 at halftime like the Raiders are now. What are some things that you would probably tell your team in the second half?
Well, I told them this is what they're doing. They just went to Ross, and they have to spread the ball around and not lose confidence and try to just nitpick away and get one in, and then hopefully getting one in, they get another one in and go all the way down.
Joe Barrett with the run that time. Barrett picked up some good yardage for the Raiders, and they are in Cowboys territory now with a first down to boot.
Marty, obviously this is a flag football program that you run over in the Morgana League, but you are involved with the tackle football and the Muni football at Stella Walsh. Maybe you can tell us briefly a little bit about what is Muni football and what it's done.
Well, Muni football is a program in the city of Cleveland that I've been involved with 25 years. And it gives opportunity for kids 12 and under in the division I'm playing to play tackle football. Kid can't weigh over 123 pounds. And we play ball games once a week against other clubs from all over the city of Cleveland.
A lot of the youngsters we see here out here today, Marty, had played for you in Muni football. Now this has given them an opportunity to go on and keep playing some football.
Well, what it does for our organization is our football players usually get done with us in the seventh grade. And it gives some of the seventh and eighth graders an opportunity, and ninth graders an opportunity to play football before they go on to high school and can get involved in the high school program.
Raiders facing a second down situation. They need about 3 yards. Barrett at quarterback. Now he splits out wide to the left. And Barrett will receive the pass, pick up the first down, and nearly go for a touchdown. So we've seen that play three successive plays in a row. And Tim, maybe you can help me out here, but we don't have a number two listed on our roster. The quarterback that comes in there for Barrett starts out at wide receiver and slips across. Maybe Marty knows.
All right, I'm trying to figure out who it was. I thought it was Hupsey, but it isn't Hupsey.
It's not Jack Fargo, is it?
I believe so.
The mystery man at quarterback.
Okay, we got Barrett.
No, we got Barrett.
Now at quarterback. This guy in motion, Marty.
That's Hupsey.
Hupsey. It's George Hupsey wearing number two.
George Hupsey will get the shotgun, and he'll get the pass, and it's picked off. So Hopsey's pass blocked at the line of scrimmage, and it's blocked that time by Lindemann, and then picked off for the Cowboys by Robert Boneline.
Robert, again, is one of players that played for Marty in Muni football.
Definitely.
Comes up with a big pass, and we see here Anthony Littleman coming up. Talked about the pressure. Littleman and Ortiz early in the ball game. We can see here a batted pass and a turnover. Again, drive by the Raiders sustained by a turnover.
Ed Farmer at quarterback now for the Cowboys. Pass out. Actually, that wasn't Farmer. That was Julius Johnson. So Johnson lined up at quarterback for the Cowboys. Of course, Chris Osborne has played there most of the night. And getting back to the Raiders, driving fairly well there in the first series of the second half, and needing a touchdown, no doubt, down 31-6. That interception will obviously hurt. Johnson once again back at quarterback for the Cowboys. Cowboys in their own end of the field. Johnson with trouble, and Julius Johnson will be flagged down at about the 3-yard line.
That's Russ Agostino. Again, we've called his name quite a bit, Ron. He's been in there on the pass rush. One of the things is the coach talked about pass rushes from both teams. This is one time the Raiders come through and come up with the sack.
I believe that Ross was the person that would make a difference here in the ball game. I thought his rushing abilities would have put the Raiders in the ball game. But the Cowboys seem like they have negated him by going to the outside.
Well, Mario, getting off of the flag just for a second, you're going to be going into a big playoff game this weekend. You beat Pal number 6-0. You're coming back. You got to beat them again. What kind of things do you go into preparing for a game? And, they always say it's tough beating a team twice in one season, especially back-to-back. You have them at the end of the season, and now you come back here, and you're going to play them the first round of the playoffs.
Well, it's definitely going to be a rough thing, but I think our young men this Saturday have showed themselves that they can play football. I think it will be a good ball game. It'll be a hard-hitting ball game. One thing about our team, we do not have team speed, but we do hit, and we do operate as a team unit.
That's one of the things we stress. And hopefully, if they play as well as they played last week, we'll be in the ballgame.
Well, we want to wish you the best of luck and hope you bring home a title for your recreation center.
Well, I don't know about the title, but I'll tell you this much, Tim. We'll be out there. We'll give it the best shot we can, and we're really enjoying being where we're being in the playoffs of Muni football.
Johnson heaving one deep to Farmer. Farmer goes up, and he brings it down, and Ed Farmer will be caught barely by Joe Barrett. Wow. That one almost went 78 yards for a touchdown.
Well, again, Ren, we had talked about when the coach had mentioned, what are your, some of your concerns? He said the speed of the Cowboys as well as the size of their wide receivers. They outmatched the defensive backs. Obviously, free safety Joe Barrett made the difference there, preventing a touchdown.
So suddenly, the Cowboys no longer in their own end of the field. They are now in Raider field position at about the 32-yard line. Johnson again at quarterback. Little dump pass to Ortiz this time, and Ortiz, I tell you what, they're having a hard time finding the flag on Ortiz's waist there, and Santo gets all the way down inside the 20-yard line. Tim, I've been watching and looking, and I do not see Osborne out on the field at all. We talked about Johnson getting in there at quarterback, and Chris Osborne, of course, quarterback the whole first half.
I believe the coaches, Barney James, has given this man a chance here. He was a quarterback at the beginning of the year, and I think Chris is out of the ball game, and he's not really trying to run up the score, and he's letting his other quarterbacks play at this time.
And Johnson, the quarterback, goes in for a touchdown. Julius Johnson with a heck of a run there, a couple of spin moves to avoid tacklers, and he goes in for a touchdown.
Ren, I don't know if they called it in. I didn't see a hand go up. I thought one went up, but I see, I think they're ruling that they stepped out and putting the ball on the 2-yard line. We'll look at the replay here as we see Ed Farmer coming out to the right here. Nice spin move. Missed tackle, comes up here on the 2 now. It's not near the sideline, but apparently they ruled the tackle at the 2 by Joe Barrett, number 5.
Yeah, they got him right there at the end. So nonetheless, a real nice run by Julius Johnson that time. And Johnson finishes it off with a touchdown. Yes, they call it a touchdown this time.
Johnson on the carry.
So a touchdown for Julius Johnson. Johnson, 12 years old. Wow, 5'8", 125 pounds, a seventh grader at A.B. Hart School. Pretty big 12-year-old, Tim.
Well, if I remember right, Marty, is this the guy that plays some basketball at the Cleveland Rec Centers?
Yes, he does. He plays in our league. And he plays in our league at Lady Alerts, and he plays for Stella Walsh in the Class F program.
Johnson's pass over the middle to Ortiz for the two-point conversion fails. So the Cowboys get the touchdown at 6 points. They'll go up 37-6. That was play number 12 in the third quarter, so just two plays left here in the third quarter. The Cowboys with a commanding lead.
Marty, we've talked a little bit about Muni football and flag football, but maybe we can share with some of the viewers some of the upcoming programs that Stella Walsh has to offer coming around the months of December and January they can get into.
Well, one of the things we're looking forward to is a soccer league for 12 and under. That'll be starting up in November, and one of the greatest things we have at Stella Walsh, which we get anywhere from 35 to 45 participants, is our swim team. Our swim team is always one of the biggest in the city, and we're always battling for the championship with Esterbrook Recreation Center. Our kids are out there stroking it in the water and looking forward to that season to start. Most naturally, we'll be going into basketball, but that won't be until December. So those are the next two things really coming up at Stella Walsh Recreation Center.
Okay.
Cowboys set to kick off to the Raiders. We're two plays away from the end of the third quarter. Cowboys enjoying a very, very fine evening tonight here in the championship game of the Morgana League. Ortiz with the tackle.
We've been calling Santo Ortiz's name quite a bit tonight, Ron. It's been on offense, or it's been on defense, it's been sacks, it's been run backs. Kind of a complete ball game for the whole team, the Cowboys. One of the things that Barney James impressed upon me when we talked is, hey, we're going to spread it around. We're going to get everybody involved, and they've accomplished that tonight.
That's Barrett with the reception, and Barrett gone for the touchdown. No flags present, so Joe Barrett will have himself a 50-yard touchdown.
Well, we talked about his speed all night long. We see now why Joe Barrett is the leading scorer of that league. Again, we've had two touchdowns by Joe Barrett. This is one time where he just completely outruns it. It's all speed, something you can't teach. Again, one nice move to the inside, and he's looking nothing but the goal line.
Yeah, Barrett with a real nice move on Farmer to get to the inside and then break away for a touchdown. George Hopsey, the quarterback, that threw the touchdown pass to Barrett, but Barrett pretty much did it all his own after he caught the football.
One game this year, Mr. Barrett had six touchdowns in one ball game in one of our games. That's not counting extra points. He's been player of the week with us at Stella Walsh. We have a player of the week every week, and Joe's one heck of a ball player.
Joe Barrett with the football, looking for the three-point conversion into the corner of the end zone. They've got it. Joe Barrett to Hopsey. Hopsey comes down with the touchdown or the extra point. Catch, and that'll be good for three.
Well, George, look here at the replay. This is again a pass to George Hopsey, 13-year-old, eighth grade at A.B. Hart Junior High. Again, you can see here, nice two-handed grab on the scoreboard, in the scorebook. George Hopsey, honor roll student.
I didn't go in there.
No, we can talk all we want about athletics, Ron, but academically, if it's not there and they don't do the academic side of it, this is all for naught. You know, we need the education, and that's one of the biggest things that we've tried to emphasize in our recreation programs is, listen, be in school, be the good student, do the things that are right, and everything else will come to you.
Well, you know, Tim, you look down the list here, and you said Hopsey honor roll, Jack Fargo perfect attendance, Ross Augustino honor roll. Perfect attendance and honor roll for Adam Kowalski. Perfect attendance for Henry Josiah. Ed Farmer there with the return for the Cowboys. But a lot of kids out there tonight with a lot of things to be proud about. And as you said, not talking athletically.
Well, Tim, I'll tell you one thing. I'll tell you that the Raiders will go out fighting all the way out here. That's one thing about this team. They will try their best and not give up.
That's the tradition at Stella Walsh, right, Marty?
My philosophy at Stella Walsh is don't tell me who you are, show me who you are. And I try to imply that on my youth today because I got a lot of kids that tell me how great they are when it comes to playing, they ain't diddly. But I'm telling you the truth. It's a lot of people talk the talk, but can't walk the walk. And we try to teach them, there's nothing wrong with talking the talk, but you got to walk the walk. And if they do that, everything's fine.
That incomplete pass by the Cowboys brings an end to the third quarter. 14 plays into the quarter, so we will move to the fourth with the Cowboys in a commanding lead over the Raiders here at the Morgana Junior Championship game.
Well, Marty, listen, we want to thank you for spending some time with us, and we want to wish you the best of luck in your Muni football playoff, and you guys have done a tremendous job at Stella Walsh. Maybe for our viewers, just want you to give them the address and the phone number of Stella Walsh.
Okay, Tim, we're Stella Walsh Recreation Center. We're 7345 Broadway, 664-4658. And I would like to use this time right now to thank all my staff at Stella Walsh, league moderator Jim Clark, and everyone else who has worked their butt off and done 58 games in about a month. I think our program speaks for itself. I think our kids had a great time, and that's what it's all about, Tim.
Absolutely. Thank you, Marty.
Welcome.
Julius Johnson, a quarterback again for the Cowboys. Pass over the middle this time, falls incomplete. Johnson trying to get it to Tom Skiadowski. Cowboys up 37-15, Tim.
Where's the Raider attack? I said it was going to be close here, but they've really done some great plays. It's the penalties that have hurt them.
And I tell you what, the Cowboys have really played well. I mean, Osborne played tremendously in the first half. And the second half, Johnson's done a nice job. And we saw Ed Farmer score two touchdowns in the first half.
Pass caught by Santo Martinez.
We don't want to forget about Tony Lindemann. Lindeman had two touchdowns also. So the Cowboys as a team have played just outstanding tonight. Cowboys with a fourth down situation here, and they've decided to punt. So Lindeman will take the ball. That's Tony Lindeman right there with the red shorts, number five, with the football for the Cowboys. And he will be punting to the Raiders. The Raiders with the football and with a pretty good return. Once again, special teams does a nice job for the Raiders. On the return for the Raiders, Tony Cieslak. Cieslak, a 12-year-old, 5-footer, 95 pounds, 7th grader at A.B. Hart School. I remember when I was 95 pounds. I wasn't in 7th grade. I was 95 pounds when I was a sophomore in high school.
You know, I keep telling everybody, when I was younger, I was that weight, Ron. I don't know what happened, but when you guys were out there at that age, did you guys have programs like this? Did you get those opportunities?
Well, I grew up in a very small community out in Lorain County, and we had a thing called Pee Wee football out there. Never played that, but I spent most of my summers and falls on a baseball field in the hot stove leagues, and I know how important that was to me. You know, my father took me through that, and my brother, the whole family, and I think these things are really important, and it's the kids should feel lucky that they have the opportunities to do things like this.
Yeah, well, we look out here and we see some of the parent support. It's so important, especially with our teenagers, that mom and dad support them, give them that support to get through. Things are so rough out here today that they need some positive alternatives. They need to know that mom and dad are behind them.
Raiders with the ball. That was Hopsy trying to get that pass to Barrett on the sideline. We've seen what has happened once Joe Barrett has gotten the football in his hands tonight. I mean, the kid's exciting. He can certainly make something of nothing. Fifth play of the fourth period. Morgana Junior League Championship game. The Cowboys in white against the Raiders in black, and Tony Lindeman. Tony Lindeman gave George Hopsey some late dinner on that one.
Well, when you looked at that play, you saw that defensive pass rush. Again, it was Tony Lindeman with the block. Pressure by Santo Ortiz. You see it here. Here comes Ortiz and Lindeman up in the air for the block.
Well, when you look at it, Hopsey's 5'3". Lindeman goes 5'11". So right there, you got 8 inches on the kid. And Lindeman took advantage of it. Penalty flag, so this one's coming back no matter what. And we have an interception. Ed Farmer intercepts the ball right in front of Joe Barrett. And Farmer gets down to about the 30-yard line.
Flag on the play.
I don't think Ed liked how Joe pushed him out of bounds there, but cooler heads have prevailed, and we'll find out what the penalty's about. Now the penalty flag was thrown immediately as the play started. My guess is it's offensive. You know, it's an offensive penalty, which would, obviously the Cowboys would take the interception and take the football.
We had two penalties.
Two penalties.
We had offside on the black. We had unsportsmanlike conduct after the interception on white. It'll be 15 yards from the spot of the unsportsmanlike conduct. It'll be white ball. Yeah!
So there's your penalty, an offsides on black. But after the interception, we had an unsportsmanlike penalty on Ed Farmer for the white. So they'll get a 15-yard penalty out of that. So the Cowboys, wearing white, will get the football, but not in the field position that they had it after the interception.
Well, Ed Farmer's had a pretty good day. He's had two interceptions. One return for a touchdown, and obviously, one of the things that Marty talked about is that you do it out here on the field, show me, don't tell me about it, and I'm sure the timeout that's being called right here is Barney James basically to cool everybody down. and keep everybody focused on what they're out here about.
Time out. Cowboys.
Yeah, we've seen a real nice football game so far tonight, Tim, and all three games that we've seen tonight have been well played and sportsmanlike, we certainly wouldn't want to see anything less right now.
You know, and really, Marty hit a key point, Ron, when he was up here about staffs that have done an outstanding job. I mean, we come out, we see a championship game, but all year the people that work in the recreation department, the rec instructors that are the league directors that work at the centers that become the officials, the scorers, the monitors, you know, that put it all together, without their efforts in making this a quality program, it doesn't happen. You know, when you go from 300 kids to over 2,000 kids, it's really a tribute to those workers.
It certainly is, and like you said, it can't happen without them. Cowboys with the football, that's Ortiz with the ball, and Ortiz down at about the 22-yard line. Ninth play of the fourth quarter.
Carry by Santo.
Cowboys in white up over the Raiders in black, 37-15.
First down.
Tim, the evening drawing to a close for us tonight. I don't know about you, but my toes feel like they've been sitting in a freezer. Ortiz again with the carry. Joe Barrett with the tackle.
Carry by Santo Ortiz. Tackle by Joe.
Well, we can see here that he's put Ortiz at quarterback, and basically I'm sure he starts to say, hey, let's just run the football. Pick up some first downs. You know, Ron, really, our special thanks has to go out to you. We know you do an outstanding job with Channel 43 Sports, and all the excitement and things that you've done for the community and the city of Cleveland really have gone noticed. And you, our tribute and special thanks for you coming out here tonight and making this a reality.
My pleasure, too.
Dr. Ortiz pass complete to Ed Farmer.
Farmer on the reception there from Ortiz.
First down.
A first down for the Cowboys. They are now inside Raider territory at about the 37-yard line. Ortiz again at quarterback. Ortiz will keep it himself. And the penalty flag. So Ortiz picks up about four, but we'll have
carry
to wait and see what the penalty is all about.
Ross Augustino, flag on the play.
I think what's happened here is, and again, the officials will talk about it and they're waving it off. What has really happened here is that you'll see that Ortiz ended up actually hurdling, but there was a player on the ground. So again, obviously, the hurdle rule means jumping with no one there. If there's someone there, obviously jump over is perfectly legal. That's why they're waving off the penalty.
Second down situation for Ortiz and the Cowboys. Ortiz dives for a first down.
Carried by Santo Ortiz, talk about Joe Barrett.
That was the 13th play of the fourth quarter, so this will be the last play of the football game. The Cowboys in white, 37. The Raiders in black, 15. The final play of the game here, the Morgana Junior Championship. Ortiz with the football, and this game is over. Joe Barrett makes the final tackle on Ortiz, and that's it, Tim. The Cowboys beat the Raiders 37-15, and they are the Morgana League champions of 1994.
Well, when we come back, Ron, we're going to meet the outstanding player and the winning coach of the Morgana League championship game.
Okay.
We'll be right back.
Good night, ladies and gentlemen.
Just like moons and like suns, with the certainty of tides, just like hope springing high, still I rise. Bringing the gifts that my ancestors gave, I am the hope and the dream of the slave. And so I rise, I rise, I rise.
We'll be right back.
Hi, we're here at the end of the Morgana Junior Football Championship game, and we're here with the winning coach, Mr. Barney James. How many years have you been involved coaching the Morgana League?
This is my first year.
Your first year?
Yeah.
And going into your first year coaching, was there anything in particular that you mentioned to the players prior to the beginning of the season?
Well, I just told them to keep their heads up, because most of the time when they make a bad play, they, you know, they get down on themselves. So I just told them, you know, come back the next play.
Okay, leading into this game tonight for the championship, you mentioned certain things of tactics that you had planned for the team to go into for defense and offense?
Right. On defense, I'm basically told my line to keep an outside rush containment on their quarterback because he's a gifted athlete.
Okay, and towards the offense?
Offense, we got a short pass control offense, so I just basically told them to keep with the short game to control the plays.
Okay, and two of your players that I believe, which did outstanding jobs both defensive and offensively, is Mr. Edward Farmer, who is the MVP for the offense, and Mr. Santos Ortiz, which is the MVP for the defense. They had outstanding play, and we want to congratulate you. First of all, Mr. Farmer, what school do you go to, first of all, and how old are you?
I go to A.B. Hart, and I'm 12.
A.B. Hart, and you're 12. How many years have you played in the league?
Played 1 year.
This is your first year. Congratulations. Mr. Ortiz, how old are you, and what school do you attend?
I'm 15.
And how many years have you been involved with the league?
Two.
2 years. Okay. Can we look forward to seeing both of you participating again next year?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay, congratulations to both of you, and we'd like to present this trophy to both of you as being co-MVPs, one for offense and one for defense. And also to you, congratulations being the winning coach.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Back to Ron and Tim.
They didn't get awards, but they certainly were deserving. Chris Osborne, the quarterback, 8 of 13, 113 yards passing tonight for 3 touchdowns. And his wide receiver, Tony Lindeman, both played outstanding tonight.
Well, you know, when Barney James talked about his team, he talked about offense and defense and the pass rush. Obviously, Anthony Lindeman, Chris Osborne, Santo Ortiz, Ed Farmer, it really wasn't just those four. They all stood out and had an outstanding game, but really when it came down to it, it was a total team effort. They spread it around. It was really an outstanding game. When we look at our final stats, Ron, we can see there was 259 total yards for the Cowboys, 148, and penalties played a big role for the Raiders. They had a couple mistakes that hurt them, especially where we had one touchdown called back early in the ball game. They had 4 penalties for 35 yards. But also when it came down to it was rushing yardage as well. They beat them in the rushing yards. They were able to run the football as well as throw the football. They didn't make any turnovers. They didn't make any mistakes. And when you're running the football, you're not creating any mistakes on your own side, then you're going to come out on the end a winner.
37-15 our final, the Cowboys over the Raiders in the Morgana League Junior Championship game. For Tim Wells, I'm Ron Janssen. We'd like to say goodnight to you. Thanks for watching. We're signing off now from Brookside Park, Elder Field.
We hope you enjoyed today's game. Make sure you head over to our YouTube channel, TV20 Cleveland, and subscribe to get the latest videos. I'm Christian Patterson. Thanks for watching TV20 Classic Sports.